What the hex?
What the damn hex?
Hello, everybody. The chat is going wild. There are too many people. So hello, everybody. I'm not going to name.
Who was first?
That is cases. Maybe Hexy Queen. Okay, hello for you.
Welcome to What the Hex.
Where's Sandy? Where's Sandy?
Episode 11. And it's a special show because I lost access to the StreamYard. So I had a gang and array of topics prepared for today, and now I can't bring up any of this. So Peter's jumping in and running this show, and we have to kind of make it work. Also, I want to welcome our special guest, Hex for Life from the UK.
Hey, good to be here. Joining us.
Man, that's great. I think I've met you more in real life than I've met Peter, right? I think we met twice already. Weren't you in London, mate, at the Hex 2 year anniversary?
Yeah, 741, mate. 741.
Yeah, exactly. And then we were like backbenching in Vegas, I think at Maddie's conference. I think we were sitting together with Henry Hex, who's actually an original founding member of this of the Wake Up Hex show.
Where is Henry, by the way? What happened to him?
Yeah.
Oh, he's traveling the world, mate. He's having fun.
He's chilling.
Yeah. He dumped on us at 50 cents, and now.
Did he? Do you think he did, or do we know if he did?
Did what? Sorry.
Well, maybe at 40. Who knows?
We can assume. We can only assume. No, but that was fun. We were sitting in Vegas and like, you know, I'm German, right? So when we say we sit at the conference, then that's what we do. We sit at the conference and you guys were kind of playing along for the first 2 hours and then it was like off to the pub and I did not see you ever again.
That's right, man. I would come in, get my coffee, see who was on and if I didn't find it interesting, I'd go straight to the bar with the others. So yeah, it was good fun.
So you did your own meetup at the bar. That was nice. But of course, the big news of the day. Peter, run the jingle.
Which one?
The Pasussel one.
Oh, okay. 3, 2, 1.
Testnet V3 is live.
Woo! V3!
Finally!
Oh my goodness. Did you guys look at it already? Did you play along with it? Play around with it? Fiddle with it?
Tinkled. I reacquainted myself with the Testnet V2.B/3. It wasn't so exciting, right?
Now but, let's play a guessing game. How long till mainnet?
Mid-May.
Yeah, Hexo was the first to tweet. When mainnet? He was
like mid-ish May. Absolutely, 100%.
We're on track for mid-ish May.
Yeah, I'm cool with mid-ish May.
Yeah.
Hex for life. Now that my internet is unfucked itself, I have two questions for you.
Sure.
Are you Hex for life?
Yes. Absolutely. Yeah, yeah. Quite staked out for all of those 15 years.
Yeah, I'm fucked again.
Yeah. Get those t-shirts, man. That's what I've been doing. It's been great.
T-shirts.
Oh, wow. He is genuinely fucked, isn't he? He's frozen.
Oh, he's
I want question two.
Robot. Yes, unfortunately, we're having all kinds of issues today. But over to Hex for Life. So you and Hexagate, right? You are the main organizers or the brains behind the Budapest meetup. Can you tell us all about it? Or shall we run that promo video first? What would you say?
Yeah, please run that video first. Yeah.
Shall we run that? So that would be the second one with the city thing. Yeah.
I've been reading books of old, the legends and the myths, Achilles and his gold, Achilles and his gifts, Spider-Man's control, and Batman with his fist. And clearly I don't see myself upon that list, but she said, where'd you wanna go? How much you wanna risk? I'm not looking for somebody with some superhuman gifts, some superhero, some fairy tale bliss, just something somebody I can kiss. I want something just like this.
Wait a minute. I saw some pretty risque images there that I must protest. Or at least
I saw a Jägermeister.
Two shots I remember from the beginning. Somebody was drawing a vagina in the sand. What was that about? and then there were two men that were kind of getting on with each other behind like kind of some kind of obscure thing. That's very interesting too. And then the final question is, why are there like 98% women at this event? And may
because it's Budapest.
Oh, I see.
And they're all beautiful.
Wow, that's right. They were very nice ladies there. Yes.
So that's what it's going to be like.
Imagine all those bikini-clad women to be crypto nerds, you'll get a more accurate representation.
Perfect female, crypto nerd, lovely bikini-clad women.
Well, you know, there may be women because we've got in the Hex community, we've got more women than any other crypto community. So, you know, and we've been getting in touch with some women too. So, you know, it's not just going to be all a sausage fest, but it will probably be a majority men. Of course, we'll see. We'll do our best is what I'll say.
But if there are a majority of men, at least they can draw vaginas in the sand.
Absolutely. They can draw whatever they like. They can make their dreams come true in sand form. Yeah. Nice.
I have some background news for you guys. There is Captain RG3 in the green room lurking on us. What the hell is that?
Hello and happy V3 to everybody.
What the heck?
What in the heck? Peter, pleasure to see you. I haven't seen you in so long. Hex,
yeah, buddy. Yeah. How you doing? I'm
also what the fuck?
RG, I'm mostly asleep and during Friday hangout, so.
DJ Cryptomatic, good to see you guys. Good to see you, Captain.
What's up?
You know what? It was such a special day last night that I just wanted to make sure.
What am I chopped liver here, Mr. Captain?
I just said Papa B.
Oh, you didn't see that. One more kiss, please. Thank you. Nice to see you.
Our security expert.
Papa B, now they caught us out. Now they know we're running this show. Like,
oh, damn it,
bosses,
we've been found
the
out.
Bosses what have the found out.
Who the heck's told about what the heck's?
For 10 episodes, we were safe. And now the
I know.
The
then 11, and
out.
It all goes to shit.
Well, I let you guys be for a long time. Like, just do your thing. I said, I got to step out and let them guys do their own thing. They're doing great.
In the choke chain.
Nope. I'm literally just here to show you guys some love. And thank you for continuing on and continuing to be the message during this whole bear market. You guys kept going not a lot of hexagons did. We lost a lot of good ones along the way and you guys didn't waver. So hats off to you. Thank you.
It wasn't easy.
you're damn right. It wasn't. We got some scars. We've got some battle wounds for sure. You know? But it forged us. It made us stronger than we even were in the beginning, and this next run is ours. I mean, this next DeFi run is ours, and that's why I'm going to take it on the road. If you guys haven't heard, I'm going to go on and do a road trip across the U.S. Yes. We're going to do a city every month. SJ is going to have the bus all logoed out, and we're going to talk about the Richard Hart ecosystem and DeFi, true DeFi, and real DeFi, and real projects that are going to be launching into it. And of course, Pulse and PulseX and Hex is going to be the goat of the whole program because nothing is better. And we can see that. Look how strong Hex is, you know, even during this this little freak out right now. Everybody's freaking out about V3. Oh, my gosh, V3. But, you know, I think that people need to really start. And I was hoping that, you know, Papa was going to be here and he was going to be able to reiterate this. But right now, more importantly than anything, security is the biggest, biggest issue. And you only using Richard Hart Wynn's tweets to go to links, to get links, stay away from everybody and everything else out there. There are scams on top of scams on top of scams getting released, and they're coming after you, Hexagons. So those bags that you've started to build or you've built, protect them. Protect them well and don't listen to anybody. Don't answer DMs. Watch out for emails. You got to keep your stuff safe. And then listen to Papa when he talks about physical security and how to handle your wallets and take care of them. And, you know, it's go time, guys. Pulse is around the corner, like literally around the corner. And we've got to watch ourselves, because there's going to be people that get wrecked. Unfortunately, I'm going to hate to hear the stories, but we're going to see it.
Already, it started, RG3. It started already, and I don't like it, and I want people to wise up and just catch anyone you see who is kind of lost their way or starts tweeting about, hey, how do I get my tokens on my MetaMask? Oh. Catch them right away and say no.
Yes. No. Don't ask questions in the general public. Always go to people, that Hexagons, that you know and trust and have a relationship with to help you to get answers. Don't go out there looking for things. Don't Google things and try and find links. Just be careful, guys. And I know that people are already getting wrecked, but just, gosh, I can't reiterate that anymore right now, because it's the biggest problem is that it's taken so long for Pulse Chain to launch. And we've had so much hype and there's so much vitriol towards this community that there are scammers that have been getting their products produced and ready, and they're ready to go. They launched last night, basically. So just realize there are some very intricate scams out there that are going to be coming after Hexagons.
There's also a fake airdrop being promoted, a Hex airdrop on Twitter, and they post their message under prominent Hex posts. So for all the new people joining the ecosystem right now, please be careful. There is no such thing as a free Hex airdrop. That's not happening. And they're only out to get your stuff. So don't connect to these websites and block.
Put Alan in timeout. Put Alan in timeout.
$5 for the super chat. He paid his way.
I'll tell you what, the oldest people on this stream are Xers, motherfucker. We are Xers.
That's right.
Ain't that right, Papa?
We're Xers. Damn right.
Xers. We ain't anything close to boomers. They raised us. Those fuckers raised us.
Yes. Yep. And they destroyed the environment, and they got those pensions, and we got the shit end of the stick. We've been cleaning it up.
We got the shit end of the stick. Most of us were raised really by our grandparents, because all those boomers were so damn high and partying and cocaining themselves up all the time that we were with our grandparents all the time. So
the least wild war, 60s and 70s.
The best generation. Yeah, the best generation actually really raised the Xers.
I like to think that they were out there having unprotected sex.
And they were.
We had to actually wrap that rascal. That was our whole generation, right?
That's where all of our siblings came from. And then... And then we were the ones that had to rap and had to deal with AIDS and all that other shit that came out.
That's right. That's right. Thank you very much.
Party freaks.
And then we
got the impetulant children after that, that came after our generations. All you little impetulant little bastards.
And then our parents gave all their money to our fucking kids.
Right. Oh, Xers are going to rule this world. I'm telling you. Those of us, we're going to end up ruling the world, and you guys are going to rue the day. Rue the day, because we will not forget all that you've handed. You know what? One of the biggest things, Baba, is that I remember getting dropped off by my parents were hippie freaking party peoples, right? I remember getting dropped off, you know, at the grandparents' house, like all the time, every weekend, half the week, after the weekend, I was there all the time, all the time. Guess where my parents are now? They moved as far away from me as they could, so they don't have to. My kids have never spent one evening with any of my grandparents, with any of their grandparents. They hardly see them. They're like, yeah, good luck on that, guys.
Yep.
I'm telling you. Hexer's got a bone to pick.
So before we go back to Hex for Life, because this was really supposed to be his, his moment to shine.
That was with the, that was Hexer talk. Meetup.
But Captain, can you tell us real quick about your Wednesday shows, the DeFi Syndicate with Famous? How has that come along? Are you sticking to these time slots, or because you're doing great numbers there?
We moved the time slot so that Famous isn't doing it at 3-4 o'clock in the morning.
Because he's like in Europe,
but he's up all the time, so it doesn't matter. If you want to see Famous, want to hear Famous, all you gotta do is go into the Twitter Spaces, and he's in there like all. I don't know when the guy sleeps. So we moved the time so it was a little more. He was a little more coherent, and so it's 5 o'clock Pacific Standard Time in the afternoons. We do Wednesdays DeFi Live. And kind of bridging the younger generation with the older generation with a little bit of sensibility and a little bit of crypto talk and trying to kind of calm everybody down a little bit and look into the tenets of what Richard Hart has put out there. And the tenets of what Richard Hart has put out there, and again, Papa can agree with this, are just good investing habits that have been around for years. There's nothing new that Richard has put out that's like, oh, it's nothing new. It's like, let's get rid of this sloppy, degenerate crypto trading space and turn it into what it should and could be. So he made products that fit into the old traditional financial freaking stability investment products. That's what HEX is. That's all it is. It's a certificate of it's the old thing that we were taught as kids that is what you're supposed to do is put your money away and let it save and earn interest. And that's all it is. It's a stupid old product. And it happens to be on some really cool new technology. And that's the cool part of it. And that's the part that the young folks understand. But we've got to move away from this degenerate trading and into, you know, real, true, old, time-tested tenets of investing. And that's all that we're doing here. And that's what DeFi really is a better way to do old time tested financial products that can make you eventually rich or retire or whatever one day. We happen to be in the volatility stage. We happen to be in the stage where a lot of money is going to be made over the next, you know, few years. So you're in at the beginning of this. But that's what we've got in front of us, you know, and that's what we're teaching over at DeFi Syndicate. And I'm trying to bring the younger folks in by using Famous and his brilliance so that because he is open-minded and he does understand. And so his attraction and some of my freaking hard knowledge, freaking, you know, old time-tested rules go together, and we bring DeFi Syndicate on Wednesdays, and then of course F and Hangout every Friday night has never
this
stopped.
Wednesday show is the subtitle Rant versus Rant. You and
sometimes,
yeah, sometimes. He had a little freak out last night. If you didn't see it, he had a little freak out last night.
Oh, okay.
We started early because Pulse Testnet V3 launched like about 35-40 minutes. Before our show. So we went ahead and launched early, and we brought up Testnet V3 and we started working on it. And he started doing things on PulseX and started freaking himself out.
And, seeing the ratios were all out of whack.
Well, he was creating liquidity pools with the same tokens and then taking those tokens and creating more liquidity pools. And I told him, I didn't look, I was trying to pull it up and I said, you know, this is stupid. This is horrible video. This is not a good show. Us just sitting here trying to, you know, do stuff on V3. I said, we got to stop. We just need to let everybody know, okay, we're going to be up all night playing with V3. Everybody go and play with V3. We don't need to talk about it yet because everything we talk about is going to have another question with a different answer that we don't understand. And we just leave it alone. It's V3's here, guys. Let's be excited about it. And so... He got excited a couple times.
And that's the end of the story.
RG3, the main question is, are you coming to Budapest meetup?
Am I coming where?
To Budapest.
can you find Budapest?
Oh, Budapest. Yeah. Budapest. Capital I've heard of Europe. That place. So I've been asked to go to Europe a couple of times now. So I'm married for 22 years. You know, so it's like I can leave once a month, I was told. you know, on a trip.
You bring the sand to the beach. It's okay. Bring your wife.
Wife. Says the man who moved across the world to marry his wife and raise
his family. Exactly. Yes. Yes.
And has never returned.
That's right. Because it was all mine over here. Yes.
So, I'd like to get to Europe. We'll see how this tour goes and how, you know, we'd like to start it in the US, and we are going to have SJ out there driving the bus. We're going to wrap it like a pirate ship, you know, and put the logos, Pulse Chain logos and everything on it. And she's going to drive that from location to location. And we're going to do a DeFi show with some of, you know, the people that are building on Richard Hart's ecosystem that have proven themselves, that have decent products out. That we're gonna bring them onto the show too. It'll be like a 4-hour day. We're gonna talk security. We're gonna talk about the history of crypto, where it came from, you know, Bitcoin, Ethereum, the different iterations of crypto, and as it's moving along. And then we're gonna DeFi, end in DeFi, and have a real long conversation about DeFi and why Hex is true DeFi and why the Pulse Chain and the Dex PulseX are gonna make DeFi better, true, finally, for the first time, which is going to open up the world to a lot of different things. I don't think people realize that, you know, not only is Pulse Chain going to make Hex better and Pulse X going to make Hex better, but Pulse Chain itself is going to make other products better that are out there that are trying to be DeFi. So I think it's going to take the attention away from all the crap that's out there and bring it over to what real crypto should look like, which is, I mean, Richard Hart's ecosystem, guys. We got lucky. We got into the middle of it because the regulators are after, you know, the middlemen. They're after companies and anybody who's custodian to other people's crypto. And that's not us. That's not what Richard Hart did. And so all eyes are not on me. They're on them. And we've seen that with this whole SEC debacle. You know, they came after us, but there's nothing there. It's like, well, what do you want from us? We're an organic community. These guys come into this room every morning.
In meantime, FTX failed, SVB failed, and all the other banks failed.
Celsius. Yep. Yeah.
What the so hell guess are what?
The banks. And the banks.
We need some DeFi banks. And once we get some DeFi banks, then you know, we won't have to worry about that system, and you know,
they'll hand that right over. They'll just grant all these licenses. It'll be so easy. They'll love to be replaced, these guys, no problem.
Yeah,
I mean, it was just this morning the SEC is threatening Coinbase now to go after their staking.
Justin Sun got served too.
Justin Sun, kind of the same fashion as Kraken. But that again is also very much USA centric, because in Europe we can still stake on Kraken just fine. Like, you can Polygon Matic, you can stake up there. You shouldn't, because not your keys, not your coin. But that's still working. And I guess to keep it fair and same, they are now also going after Coinbase, who offers similar services, I guess.
Yeah, cool. Let me spank somebody real quick, because that's something I like to do. Hey, thank you. Fuck you. First of all, Famous is a smart young man, and he is a young man. So yeah, of course, all young men like to hear themselves talk. That's what they do. That's what we do as young men. That's how we get our voice. So fuck you one more time. And then the other thing is, shame on me for thinking he's a genius. No, he's smart, and I know smart. I do know smart. And give Richard some respect. Where the fuck have you been for the last 3 years? I've been giving Richard nothing but respect. Nothing but respect. So you need to shut the hell up. Huh?
Who are you addressing, sir?
Thank you in the chat.
Oh, thank you. See, when you said thank you, I'm like, are you talking to me?
Thank you. Thank you for being here. Thank you for coming to the show, and thank you for commenting, because we appreciate you too. Because it's all about discourse. And if you want to slap, I'm going to slap back. And that's what you're getting right now. Because I don't do this stuff willy-nilly. And I don't do it off the cuff. I do it from the heart. All of this stuff that I've done here, everything that I've built, cost me time, money, heartache, death threats, you name it. It's cost me. I've made nothing off of any of this by giving Richard his due respect. So give me some fucking respect and stop talking to me like that. Thank you.
Anyway, X for life. How much X time for do life. Have?
Are you still here?
How's it going, brother?
Good you to see you.
Yeah, sorry, what? Hello. Hi.
All right, back to Budapest. So 15th of July, right?
Okay, Budapest. I'd love what to go to Budapest. Let me look it up on the map us? Real quick.
Yeah, let me look it up on a map.
Yeah.
Google.
It's close to Vienna. Yes.
I think it's Vienna. Okay, now you're look at that place.
That's in Europe. Okay.
Mm. Oh, dude. It's the capital of Hungary.
Okay. Oh, yes.
Wow, look at Budapest. You know what? My brother just went there for his anniversary. Wow. Or not his anniversary. His what do you call it? The it's been so long since I did it. He got married.
The stag. Stag.
Well,
that's
no.
Honeymoon.
Honeymoon. Honeymoon.
Honeymoon. Yeah. Usually you go there for the stag night.
yeah. Oh boy, what's that?
Yeah, that happens.
You come back with the penicillin shots.
I'm trying to. No. He went there. He went there with his new wife.
That's and before you get
my brother. I was my brother's really square. He was the good one of the family.
Yeah.
Let's see. I'm trying to see a map. Why isn't it giving me a Google map on this thing? Oh, because I ended up in Wikipedia. Screw them.
Of course.
Screw them.
Here come the boogie.
Captain, is your computer plugged in?
X for life. So give us quick some updates, some measurement about it because it's just RG3 talking all the time.
Yeah, right. Here we go.
It's truly what the heck.
So here we have a go. So when I met DJ Cryptomastic in Vegas last year in March at Maddie's thing, there were a bunch of people that I met that were from Europe, and we didn't, to be fair, spend that much time in the conference. We were basically in the bar. So we thought, right, we were, you know, looking at the conference, some of the things that we liked, some of the things that we didn't like. I thought, how would we do things, and why should the Americans have all the fun, right? So we thought, okay, let's see if we can come up with our own meetup. We're not going to do a conference. We're not going to do an event. We're going to do a meetup and just get as many people there as we can. So we started planning from that point onwards. And after that, I think it was a couple of months ago, we just went, right, I think things are going to turn around for Hex. Shall we get planning this properly? Shall we do it this summer? And they were like, yeah, let's do this. So Hexagade, who makes all the wonderful memes, he did the Last Samurai, he did the Matrix video, he does a lot of amazing stuff. I met him in Vegas, and
he can sing too.
He's a true Viking. That boy is like true Viking. He's a statue of a man, real Viking.
Yeah, he's good. So we were chatting with him, and then we've got, you know, our little group of people that we met out in Vegas. We went, okay, let's do this properly. So we started thinking, okay, how are we going to do this? And Hexagade has a friend who works out in Budapest. And then we started talking to the guys in the Hex Hungary group. And we've got an admin from there on board now. So he's on the ground. So if there's any translation problems or anything like that, he's given us so many good ideas. So the first thing we're going to do, we thought, okay, which weekend? We've gone for the 14th and 15th of July. That weekend is going to be the weekend of the Budapest Hex Pulse Chain meetup. So we didn't know that V3 were going to be launched. We didn't know that it might even be mainnet by that point. Who knows, right? And we thought, well, Hex Pulse Chain, here we go. And we chose Budapest because we were, at the time when we were talking about it, we were still in a bear, and Budapest and Hungary is actually quite cheap compared to a lot of the surrounding countries. So we thought, right, let's do Budapest.
Maybe Slovakia and Bratislava, it's okay.
Yeah.
But when is that going to be?
14th and 15th of July is when we are doing this. And what we've got, we are planning three events is what we're trying to do. So on that video that we played over about half an hour ago now, that if you can remember back to then, we had two different things that we're planning. So the first thing you would have seen was a beach called Lupa Beach, which is going to be the Saturday afternoon. And that's going to be a more sort of chilled out meetup kind of vibe for that one. But we are also hiring a boat. So on the Friday, we are hiring a boat. We're going to start around sort of 5 or 6 in the evening and have 4 or 5 hours going up and down the Danube, watching the sunset. And the packages they offer are unbelievable. You know, they are sort of top shelf booze, I mean, and nice food for quite a low price, really. Mm. So we thought, okay, let's try and get this booked. So the reason I'm on your show now rather than a bit closer to the event is that we want to offer an early bird ticket, because the boat that we're looking at only has 120 spaces. Now, if we get a lot of interest over the next couple of weeks, we can always hire a bigger boat. But we thought, all right, let's offer 120 tickets and see the interest. So the best way to find out about that is in the Telegram group. So the Telegram group is, I think it's called Hex Budapest 2023, I believe.
I put it down below in the description so people
can. It's in the description. Fantastic. So we have that group. That's where the tickets will be bought. It'll be on there. I'll be in all sorts of groups on Telegram as well. I'll be going into the Crypto Sparbook group, in the German group. We have most of the European countries covered in terms of the representation we've got. So we're trying to get the word out to as many people as possible. But the first place you're going to hear about it is in that Telegram group, in the Hex
Hex for Life. For inspiration. To interest everybody and everybody in the chat, I recommend seeing the movie Triangle of Sadness.
Okay.
Watch that and get you in the mood for this boat cruise. I think you'll love it. Watch the movie.
Go ahead. So what rating is that movie? Going down the Danube, is that what it's doing?
The boat, yes. It does a round trips around the center of the city. So it goes on the Danube, yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Sounds like Murder on the Nile River. Maybe that's the one.
Well, I'm always afraid of the boat trips because it's like, boats,
don't bring your keys.
Throw them over the side, right?
Don't bring your crypto.
Oh, nom nom. Good one, man. Good man.
No. Now that's Triangle of Pleasure.
I think he's talking about the
staff. No. I'm serious. Watch that movie. It'll definitely put you in the mood for this beautiful cruise, Triangle of Sadness. Watch that, Hex for Life, and come back to me.
Oh God! All right.
It was an Oscar nominee, so
All right. Yeah. Okay.
My brother really chalked that place up, so there's a chance that I might grab the wife and get out there and come visit with you guys.
Please do. Yeah.
It's a busy month, July. We may have two events that month, so it might be a busy month. But I don't got anything else to do. I'm retired now, so why not go to Budapest?
There you go. Yeah, so for that ticket, what does that include? Like, what is?
So I don't think I've set the ticket cost yet. So it will be for the early guys. It will be so for these 120 tickets, it'll be 40 euros is what we're pricing it at, and that will get you unlimited booze. It's hopefully that's reasonable, but we're getting unlimited booze and the booze is top draw. We're getting some. We're not talking about a full down sit down meal, but you will have a kind of a mini buffet that you can eat as well.
Wait. Full top shelf booze, little bits of food on a boat. What could possibly go wrong? You guys have gun laws out there?
We're not sailing the high seas. It's like a river.
A pirate ship waiting to happen right there.
Yeah, exactly.
Bring your own pirate flag. Yeah, that'll be awesome.
Yes.
I think we get a DJ as well. Yeah. I think we're going to DJ as well, but DJ Cryptomatic, you're welcome to do a set if you wish. We will discuss about that in due course.
We will discuss.
It's got the equipment to do so. And so we're only going to be on the boat probably about 4 or 5 hours, and then we will go straight from there to a nightclub. So I'm not going to say which club yet because we don't know, but this is the plan. And so we're doing that as a kind of the party day. The Friday, the 14th of July, is going to be the kind of the party day, and then the Saturday is going to be a little bit more chill. So if people don't want to do the whole like nightlife partying stuff, totally up to you. But the boat should be pretty chill, but obviously a nightclub is a little bit different. But the following day.
Excuse me. When is the seating for dinner with the captain, and when is nap time in between the boat ride and the nightclub?
And speaking of the captain, I know that he doesn't like the sausage fest, so the nightclub is better, like an all open, lots
ladies
of girls
free,
there.
Please. Ladies get on free, something like that. Give a little.
No, get on ladies for free.
always one step above.
The reason that we have the Telegram group is also so people can come with ideas as well. So nothing set in stone apart from this boat party. Nothing set in stone. So we will be releasing these tickets very soon. Early bird, €40. That's what you get for it. That will transition into a nightclub. And if you want a more chill day, it's the following day, the Saturday, the 15th, will be on Looper Beach. So as you would have seen in that video, the beach is very nice. It's literally just off the coast of, I think it's on the Danube itself. It's literally just across the way.
Yeah.
And a very nice beach. And we will do tickets for that as well, but we will literally do €2 or €3 just so we know how many people are coming. And then we can just swap that immediately for a drink. Whatever. So that's
a bartender like Isaac from the Love Boat? He gets the best drugs.
I will have to talk to the Hungarian guys about that, but yes, we shall see. But this is the other thing. We have, you know, a couple of Hungarian admins, one in particular called Stalin, the bird, not the dictator.
Stalin was a terrible guy. Why does he do it in the boat?
Stalin, the bird, not the dictator.
Oh. You have a funny accent.
Yeah, sorry about that. Well, he's been wonderful, and he's going to be our feet on the ground. So he's gone over to Looper Beach to talk to all of the people there, and
Looper Beach is it's actually separate from the Danube. It looks to be like
that's a swimming pool.
Artificial lake. Artificial lake, but it looks to be pretty big.
So you're cruising in the artificial lake.
Yeah, that's it. It's a huge beach.
Here is Danube.
Okay. I thought that was a road. All right.
No, that's the Danube. Here is the one arm of the Danube, and here is the main arm. So there's Lupa Beach. The water should be better, I guess. Okay.
Wait, but you're getting out of the pool and into the actual Danube, right?
Yeah. No. It's separate.
It just cruises the pool.
It's a basin.
It's floating in a
static. I think we're confusing the days.
Maybe not.
There we go. There we go.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
The boat is not in the artificial lake. So that is
the boat. Boat's gonna go up and here, up and down, like this on the Danube, I guess. And
that's it. Separate.
Yeah. Peter likes to stroke that big blue vein there.
Yeah.
Keep doing it, Peter.
Big blue
vein. All right. Well, that's all the time I have for you guys this morning. I appreciate you letting me come in. And, you know, I almost forgot why I didn't show up so much.
Always good seeing you.
Hey, but thank you. I really did want to come in and thank you. I was just thinking this morning of you know, I see that my YouTube alert flashes every morning, and I, you know, I'm always busy. So I just want to let you guys know every time I see that, I'm proud of you guys. I'm grateful for you guys. And I know that you guys are out there taking care of the Hex community and bringing entertainment and really good information. Even in bear market, you guys. And you know, that's and that was one kind of the things.
Thank you very much.
I appreciate you guys. And DJ Cryptomatic, of course, you too, man. Everything that you do. Papa B, you know, it's a love, hate relationship with you. but I do truly love you. You're a good man, and I appreciate you guys. Too. And good for you, and good on you, Hex for Life. I hope that thing turns out successful. I'm gonna look at the schedule and talk to the boss and see what happens. And nice. You know, any trips I can get out to go see Hexkins, man, I just love it. It's something about being out there and in front of people versus this 2D thing, you know. That's where the real magic happens, and talking to people's onboards and all that kind of stuff, you know. That's the and you too, Proof of Beard. You, even though you've disappeared and gone gallivanting around the world, having fun surfing and whatever you're doing to women out there, appreciate. No,
he's given up surfing. Now he's just sleeping in a van. That's
it. Yeah, I don't think he did very well at the surfing. He's not built for that, you know.
No.
Yeah. Oh, he's hugging trees now.
Trees. Yeah.
I knew that there was like some weird hippie crap going on underneath.
He's foraging in other people's backyards. That's the thing he does.
Well, we need to get him back too, because it's time. It's time for all the Hexkins to come out from hibernation.
Ding 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 ding. Come on back. It's dinner time, everybody.
Yeah. And Peter, thanks for, you know, steering the ship all the time, man. You're
You're the best. A lot of the time.
Yep.
Yeah.
A lot of the time. Okay. Well, I know the rest of you guys work it too. But thank you. Thank you, guys. And hey, man, V3's here. Pulse Chain's coming soon. Get ready. I'll see you guys out on the road. Wreck your show.
Bye-bye. All right. We got 15 minutes left. I think it's time for a transition joke from Finbear, Peter.
Oh, no. Which one is that? Ah, the
one with the Finnish flag.
Wait. Before we move on. Hex for life.
Guys, don't know the difference between the people who live in Abu Dhabi the people who live in Dubai. But I can tell you what the difference is. The people in Dubai, they don't like the Flintstones at all. But in Abu Dhabi, do.
You see? It's in the delivery. I think it's in the delivery.
That was terrible.
What did you want to say, worst. Papa B?
It's so terrible. It's funny.
It's so terrible. It was wonderful. It went around the horn. It was just incredible. Terrible. Mm.
There's one guy who'll be coming to Budapest. He's already said he's coming. So.
Oh, yeah, he did. Yeah.
Now,
did we cover everything Budapest related? Or
I think so. Unless you've got any questions, I think we're covered. Yeah.
Where is Budapest?
Where's the beach? Not even
funny. Go Google Maps.
And when will these early bird tickets be available, or do you not know yet?
We don't know yet, but it should be from tomorrow. If you join the Telegram group, you'll find out straight away. But I'll try as soon as the tickets are ready. I'll be spamming all the Telegram groups anyway, so you should hear about it.
Yeah, spam us too, and we will put the link in the description or share it on the show or something.
Yeah,
that'll be great. Thank you, guys. Already got an army of people waiting to shill it on Twitter as well. So we'll be there.
Is this a Bob Legay ripoff here? Dimebag Legay says, "What the heck's Cappy doing here? We in trouble?" It was Papa Cap.
I think that's him, but is that, I'm not sure.
Is that you think that's Bob?
Yeah, I think so. Oh, but my thank you for the super chat.
Weirdly, it's spamming the freaking.
All right, let's show this.
Oh, I remember that one. Jeez, that takes us back.
Okay, are you happy, Beardly, now?
Do you remember when I put the green dildo in that one? we're gonna bring that up next show. It's very
next
weird.
Show when I have my access to my stuff again, man. This is weird today.
I know. And the captain shows up and he thinks that Peter's the guy.
Yeah, it's Peter's show, but that's okay.
De facto it is today.
You're the captain now.
De facto.
It is.
I'm the captain.
What the heck? Speaking of Peter, can you share my thing with the Austrian flag? So me and Peter... do you see that?
This one.
Yeah. So we went on a jolly last weekend.
We met on neutral grounds. So.
We met on neutral ground in the beautiful city of Vienna, which is not that far away from Budapest, actually. So, so that's us. And, you know.
And proof of neck.
and people started this thing on my Twitch channel on Tuesday, like, who is taller? But Peter, I don't think we are the same size, right? I mean, I don't
most
you're the same width, but different
some like same height, basically.
So anyway, we met there, and then we in Vienna tradition, so do as the Viennese guys do, we had a fantastic schnitzel.
Yeah, it was awesome, actually.
Which almost looked like this. So the schnitzel thing is actually not German, right? That's an Austrian Austrian specialty. And then, of course, what you have to do in Vienna, you have to go on one of these with these horse carriage rides.
Wait a minute. What
I was too drunk to remember this.
What the fuck? What is it? Zoom enhance? What is going on here?
So after the schnitzel,
after the schnitzel, you left your bodies back at the schnitzel room.
No, they are tucked in the, you know,
oh, they're tucked in
the horse carriage. Yeah. And this is how you do the traditional, you know, the city tour. You actually do it in a horse carriage there.
Yes.
And then we went on the Ferris wheel.
Of course you did. This is very accurate.
Oh, wait. And you were there too.
I was there. I see this. How did I get there?
Which is weird. Like
I was always drunk. I went on the Danube cruise first, I guess.
Yeah, I thought you're big in Japan, but you actually live at the Prater Geisterbahn.
I can't even pronounce it, but yes, you're right. I do live there. Did you guys feel as sick as I did about this time? You guys were like going round and round. I was watching you, and I was just throwing up endlessly.
Especially after this.
Oh, hello, Sandy. At last, you're here.
Salute.
She made it for you, Peter.
So that's the Prater. That's the main, you know, the main attraction, I think, in Vienna is the Ferris wheel. Got to do that. Then we went a little bit shopping downtown.
I see you down there. Yes.
You see, this is how that looks in Vienna.
Uh-huh.
And
visit some Louis Vuitton.
Stores. Then we met her and.
Oh, wow.
From then it all went downhill.
She has very sensible shoes. That's what I want to say.
And in Vienna, there's always a Christmas market somewhere. So
even in summer.
Christmas in the summer.
That was the travel report. You know.
Oh, man.
But it was nice. We had fun, didn't we, Peter?
Yeah.
Except for that you took the wrong bus to the airport. Well, he said we meet 7:30 at the main train station, and he took a bus to the airport.
It's funny because back. It's Peter and he did something stupid.
Well.
All right. So
all right, gentlemen. I'm afraid I'm gonna have to pop off. So if
wait, you're not excused. Questions. It's not time to you may not leave, sir. More explaining to do. Like, are you Hex for life?
Yes. Yes, I am. Yep, OG. There we go.
Nice. Where can we find, where can everybody find you and maintain contact with you and bug and perhaps even pester you?
Okay, well, I'll be in that Telegram group all the time anyway. I'm always in the UK ones. I'm a regular panelist guy on the Hexy Bastard show on Wednesday nights. Either on there or in the Telegram. I mean, I'm quite active in Telegram, so you'll be able to find me, but mainly in that Budapest troop group.
Budapest, the Hungarian group.
The Hex Hungary, Hex Budapest 2023 Telegram, which is in the description. Yeah. I'll be in
lovely,
there.
Lovely.
All right.
Well, yes, there are two Hex UK Telegram groups now, right?
Oh yes. Don't get me started on that one. But
I would love to get you started on that one, but that's all water under the.
As you know, because you were there, I did a whole children's story on that. So you may find the clip of that and
the principal and the headmaster and all this.
Hex for life. You do realize we have like 5 minutes left for the broadcast, and you have to leave
like
early.
Eight minutes.
Do you have to go to the little boys' room or something? Is it the reason you gotta scuttle away before we all leave together? You know,
maybe he wanted to leave already 20 minutes ago, but
I think that was it.
The captain.
Yes.
It's good. I'll stick around. I didn't realize we were finishing that soon. So yeah.
We're a 1 hour format, but we give 30 minutes to the captain whenever he crashes our party. So yes, get used to that. We got to make up for lost. We had a whole list of things we were going to cover today. No time.
Nope.
But I can't wait to crash his stream in the future.
Nice.
And then read all of our list of things. It's a little bit of a.
Before we go, the main news of the day, of course, is Hex, not Hex, Pulchain V3.
Wait, what?
Testnet is live.
What?
Actually, Pussussle is live. And make sure you go to if you want to play with that, go to the original website, pulchain.com, which I have shared here, Peter, if you want to bring that up. It's the first one with all the text. Yes. So here you see everything you need to know about the Wii 3. So here you have your settings for that you can put into MetaMask. Works like Ethereum. So you just put these RPC settings into your MetaMask, and then you can play around
MetaMask
with it.
MetaMask only as the front end for your hardware wallet that is connected. God damn it. It's not just your MetaMask in the raw. It's not a secure solution. You're connecting up your hardware wallet with MetaMask, and then you're entering in these custom RPCs in your MetaMask, again, as a front end, and you should see either Ledger or Trezor One as your account. If you don't do that, you're doing it wrong.
Yes. And there is a block explorer here. Where you can actually see that it's running live. We're still on 10 seconds blocks, Peter. And and there are people making transactions, you know, here 24 seconds ago, 25 Woo! Seconds ago. So it's all live and running. And then if you click on the apps tab up here, you see the beacon explorer, which looks like this. There you can, you know, check wallet balances, etc. Or if you click on Pulse X, then you see the Pulse X exchange, which is also there. They can make trades with test tokens. You can add liquidity with raw liquidity. So really, you can play with all this stuff. What else is there? There's also a bridge. It's the Pulse Chain bridge. I don't know if this is actually working yet.
I think Richard said that it should be launched very soon.
Like okay. tomorrow.
Maybe within a year, within a day or something.
Within a year? Did you say year?
Within a day.
You just made.
Within a two within a, but the day is within the within a year. So
yeah.
This is a very, very nice, almost two round virtual breast.
It's Jupiter.
And the last thing that there is the TPLS faucet, which it says here gets you 10 test PLS. Clicking on that button, I think you can redeem 10 per day to just play around and try all the features. But please start off at pulsechain.com, and from there you get all the links to these apps. Don't click on anything else that you read anywhere else.
Speaking of reading, right? Dimebag Legai is interesting. It's not that cannot be Bob. Bob doesn't smoke that much dope and come up with these very almost incoherent smatterings of genius. Thank you, Dimebag Legai, for the 555.
You may be right.
It goes right to somewhere else.
Right to kinetics.
Right to kinetics.
All right. So we have a bit of a different outro for today's show.
Wait.
Before we do that, is there anything else that you guys
want to there's
mention?
One more thing.
Shoot.
In about 10 more hours, I guess, we're going to have the fourth installment of the Hex and Pulse Security Roundtable on Twitter Spaces. So if you haven't seen that, tweeted out by me. Please look for it and come join, because we are codifying and debating over new security stuff that's going down. We'll probably spend a fair amount of time talking about how to prep for the mainnet launch, just in case you haven't remembered to do that. And we really want practitioners in there to keep the debate hot, to bring new topics up and to do away with all the myths and get down to the facts. Thank you very much, everybody. That's what I got to say.
That's right. Follow at Boner Papa, isn't it? It's the other way around.
Reversed on the Twitter. Yes.
Reverse psychology. It's on Twitter. Link is also below in the description. And
Papa Flaccid.
Where is it?
Came
up with that one. Classic.
You know, on Tuesday when we were Wake Up Hex with Desmond, we played you the original, but because the Testnet V3 is live, I just had to do a remix. Shout out to West Crypto who did this song. with the Backstreet Boys remake, and I had to add my little spin to it. So that's the video that is linked down below, Peter, if you want to run this, and then you can
spin it. Take outro, us out. But I don't think it will run as the outro. So 3, 2, 1.
The Freddy Quotes beat.
It's too brave, but I want my heart's chain. Tell me why he forked another blockchain. Tell me why he cannot afford Ethereum's way. Tell me why I'm never losing ETH again. First, the way that it used to be, yeah. No matter the outbreak, I want you to know that after we launch V3, it's on fire, process.